Shamar, where you at?
What's up, what's up, what's up? It's your boy Big Marco. You already know what it is, period. The Queen of Atlanta, okay? The Queen of Atlanta, you hear me? So look, this what I want to say is that I'm going to be based off talking about myself and talking about how I got known, how I got famous, how I got popular, stuff like that. I need to start talking about, okay? So y'all make sure y'all subscribe, like, hit that bell notification every time I post a video, because Big Marco is back.
I'm ready.
We back. What's up? So, I'm going to talk about this, right? And I'm going to say it because I feel like I should. So, first, I was on Facebook. And I was, like, based off, I made a Facebook and stuff like that. And I would, like, post, like, videos. I would go on live. I was doing a lot. I got known on Facebook. Then, that's when I went on ahead and went on to Instagram or whatever. And I started posting more funny videos, you know what I'm saying? Just, you know, popping my shit, you know what I'm saying? I was just popping my guns and just, you know, making people there, whatever. So, the video that I put out was when I was in church and I had made a video saying so like, you know, just basically saying the song. But the song that I was listening to, it was like, all I do is think about boys. Like, that is the music that I actually did a video to. That went viral. And then my other video that I had did when I was in the kitchen, I was like, they say she was gonna punch me in my face, punch me in my face. That video definitely went viral. Then I had on a red wig, but the girl who did my wig, she like literally glued that motherfucker down to my motherfucking skull, like my real natural hair shit. She glued that shit down. I couldn't even get it out. I had to like literally cut my red hair just to get the wig off. And I went out for her and cursed out and said I would never let her do my hair ever again. So yeah, that video when I was riding down the street or whatever, they was thinking that, you know what I'm saying? They was wondering, what the fuck, what is he riding? Like, what the fuck is he riding? Like, you know what I'm saying? Is he on a bike or what? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, they think that it was just me riding with no bike or none of that. But to be real with y'all, I was riding a bike down Washington Road. So, that's what really got me famous or whatever. But the first video that got me famous was that bitch said she was going to punch me in my face or whatever. Then I had did a video because, you know, I be having people that be, you know what I'm saying, want to meet me and want to see me and love me and just love the fact that I am funny. I am a funny person that they can watch all day, look at all day. I'm talking about a lot, like, a lot. So, yeah, that's basically what it is, you feel me? I got famous off those types of videos. And so once I had got popular, that's when, you know, that's when celebrities started posting me, like Kodiak Black. Shout out to him, you know what I'm saying? He posted me on his page. Who else? Snoop Dogg. Now, salute Snoop Dogg, because, you know, that's my role now right there. Like, for real, I really, really do love Snoop Dogg. But I had got posted on his page. Then, you know, I just started been going viral. Like, getting posted by rappers. You know what I'm saying? Kodiak Black posted me. Got named Snoop Dogg posted me. Lil Duval posted me. Who else had posted me? Dre Dogg. It was just a lot of celebrities was posting me because I was going viral. You know what I'm saying? I used to do funny shit, but I'm finna come back with it now. It's time. Yeah, Big Marco is back now, boo. So, with that being said, that's basically what I've been doing. I've been, you know, going viral, getting known. I got known on my own, you feel me? And, you know, you just gotta, you know, do you and be you and be yourself. That's all you gotta do. And by the way, you just do your own shit. You don't gotta be like nobody else. You feel me? Like, I thank God that I ain't gotta be like nobody else. Because they love me for who I am. They love me for me. Not for trying to, you know, be on everybody's tail or ride people coattail. That's what they're not gonna love you for, because then they're gonna think you copy. So yeah, with that, yes. But that's basically what I'm talking about. That's basically how I got known. Okay? That's basically how I got known. Then I had put out my first music. After I started putting out music, I think y'all do remember, and I know y'all do remember. Password, Moved Around, Jamie Lincoln, and If You Love Me. Those are the four songs that I had out. Because when I put my song out, everybody was loving it. Everybody was, you know what I'm saying, dancing to it. I even had little girls, like little kids, dancing to my song. I did have a manager, but the manager wasn't doing right by me. He was just a sorry-ass manager. So, that's basically what it was. You feel me? I started doing what I do, and I'm going to continue doing it. And continue going. Come at me. They could never replace the Queen of Atlanta. You feel me? Because I am the Queen of Atlanta. You feel me? So that's how I had gotten all this stuff.
Congratulations, you're a winner, baby.
And then another thing too, when I had cleaned out my house or whatever, and I'm walking to the store or whatever, I hear my name out of the blue. Shamar, and so I turned around and stuff, and that was like, you know what I'm saying, they saw my videos, you know, that was, you know, watching my videos and stuff like that. And so then, you know, that's what was going on. And so, everybody was talking about the TikTok thing, right? But I didn't know, you know what I'm saying, what was TikTok, what they do on there, whatever. So, somebody had, you know, told me to download the app. I downloaded the app. I created a account for TikTok. And ever since then, I started, like, making videos, you know what I'm saying? I did a little fruit of video with my sounds on it and stuff like that. So, yeah. That's basically what it was. And shit, TikTok was, you know, popping, and it still is. And so, I don't make, you know, a couple of TikTok people, you feel me? I don't make, you know, Katrina and all them other people, you feel me? Isha and all them, you feel me? I mean, all them. But I also make Eric. And what I am gonna say about Eric is that I didn't know him then. I only knew him when he was hanging around someone. or whatever. But at that time, you know, everybody was cool, everybody was good, everybody was, you know what I'm saying? But at that time, you know, I was, you know, I used to like Aaron. I still do like him. But it just, things was going wrong and you know, people was finding out with each other and stuff like that. And it is what it is. So, I had saw him a couple of times and I'm like, he know these people, you feel me? And stuff like that. But somebody ended up telling me that he wanted to get to that person to get to me. And that's when he got to know me. We had met, stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? We had did a TikTok video together. And so after that, I was already thinking like, damn, Aaron is, you know what I'm saying? He cool. He a good vibe or whatever. And stuff like that. And then that's when, you know, me and him started hanging out then. And child, when me and him started hanging out, I was just like, oh yeah, he is cool. But with him, it's just like you can tell that he's a good person. You can tell that, you know what I'm saying, he'll be on no drama-fied shit. You know what I'm saying? He don't even argue with people. He don't do none of that. But when I started getting to know him, start hanging out with him and stuff like that, we was hanging out to like, we was, you know, just basically having fun. We were going to different places, stuff like that. And I'm like, damn, like, who, you know what I'm saying? Who don't send this man my goddamn way? Who, you know what I'm saying? But I guess it was God that sent him my way. Okay. We start having fun and stuff like that. And so we start like doing videos, like TikTok videos and stuff like that. Don't get me wrong, I love doing TikTok video with Eric because of a certain fact that I know him. You know what I'm saying? And I like the fact that me and him actually got to know each other and, you know what I'm saying, know each other more longer. But the fucked up thing about it was that I fucked up by trying to, you know, ask him a question and stuff like that. You know, me and him, we had all the different, but it wasn't bad. You feel me? It was just a little incident. That's all. It was just a little incident. You feel me? So, yeah, but, you know, I fucked with him, you feel me? And I thank God that I did get to know him more and got to know him even more. He's a motivation person. He will motivate you and will tell you what not to do. And he's very protective of his friends. Okay, Miss. Mm-hmm. He's very protective of his friends. And he don't even play it. You feel me? I'm not even gonna lie. Ever since I've been like a leery, been around era, I noticed this, that he always keep alert on everything, and I love that about him, period. I really do love that about him, like, no, you know what I'm saying? I love that about him. That's all I'm gonna tell your motherfucking ass. Okay. But we was out at the mall or whatever, and then, you know, people wanted to take pictures with me and stuff like that. And, you know, they was kind of afraid, like, to take a picture or ask for a picture or whatever the case may be. But I was just like, ain't no need for them to be trying to be afraid. If you want a picture, just come up and ask me. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to be afraid or whatever. But some of them, they be trying to be funny and be trying to, you know, joke around and all that. But I don't forget that I was on my phone because we was in the mall and we was, you know, looking for shit, you know what I'm saying, like shopping and shit. We was in the mall, and then I was on my phone, but he ended up telling me to pay attention or whatever. Now, Eric, he see shit like that. Bitches see shit off the motherfucking rip, and he know it, because that's just the type of person that he is, honey, okay? That's just the type of person who he are. But yeah, so he started telling me, you know what I'm saying, watch out for my surroundings, stuff like that. Because I was in my phone or whatever. And, you know, I was in my phone just you know, texting somebody on Instagram or whatever. He told me to watch out for my surroundings. Then some dude was like, you know what I'm saying, damn me to put his alcohol on Shamar or whatever. That was basically trying to do that for clout. You feel me? You know how people do it. You know, people do shit for clout because that's what they are. They're the clout chasers. You feel me? And so, that's what I love about him. And I can see myself, you know what I'm saying, just based on, you know, being motivated by him and stuff like that, because I'm super fan that me and him been on each other now. It's what, 2022? Babe, we've been on each other for a long ass time. Okay? He, like I said, some of the people think they know him, but you house don't know him, the fuck? You don't even know him, the fuck? You think you know that boy, but that bitch, you don't know him, the fuck? Stop playing no bitch. Anyway, but yeah, you don't know him like I do, boo. So yeah, that's basically what's been going on. That's how, you know, me and Aaron started getting to know each other and getting along and stuff. You know what I'm saying? He is a great friend. But one thing about it is, he don't play about his friend, and he will fight with his friend. And he ain't gonna let nobody touch her, period. Because that's just him. Yeah. Okay? Don't play. Don't play, boo. And I said what I said. So, yeah, that's basically what it is. On the other hand, we got motherfucking time. But we'll be back. We'll be back. Because this, bitch, we got time. Next, bitch.
So you're telling me there's a chance.
Now, that's part two of where Shamar at. Shamar. Now, last time we see your cousin been beating you up and chopping you with your phone. Now, you hope she ain't kill you, Shamar. All them damn back of truck you riding, your eyelash been flying. All the ring you done get into to fight for the people. Child, and you could go and hide and be mussing. You know people be waiting to see you and your little boyfriends. Y'all ain't in the hotel room no more. What going on, Shamar? Shamar, come on out them boy. Come on out there hiding now from the underground. Yeah, shit, I thought you watch it and get famous. You ain't won't be famous, Shamar, whatever you tell us. I bet you what, was bitches waiting to see what you got new, Shamar. What kind of new hairdo you got and thing? You got a new man or something? You depressed? Come on up there. You done worked too hard, Shamar. You done worked too hard. Come on, let the world see you tick and talk. We must you, Shamar. Part two. Follow us. Woo woo.
Boy, you tweaking. His type bad as hell.
Okay, we back. Big Marco is back. Child. The next topic we gonna talk about is motherfucking Ty. Ty the motherfucking goat. Bitch, I know that hoe. Bitch, I know that hoe. Okay? Let me tell you something about Ty. Ty stay out the motherfucking way, but he see shady shit too. You know? Man, he'll see eye to eye. We look at each other like, girl, we see side to side, girl, you getting what I'm getting, or, you know, yeah, okay, yeah, you know. But with Ty, I like Ty too, you know what I'm saying? Ty, he's like very, very, very cool, you feel me? And, you know, that's my girl, that's my bitch. Like, I love her. Y'all don't think you're mad about that, but I love that bitch, like, for real. I love Ty, like, that bitch right there, that should be, ooh, girl. Oh, girl, like, she said what the fuck is on her mind. She don't give a fuck, and it is what it is. Like, bitch, can we sip a tea on that? Period. That bitch don't know. That bitch don't give a fuck. That bitch don't. That bitch gonna tell her how it is. And she'll be quiet. She'll be quiet. Ty is the type of person, you know, she'll sit back and just motherfucking observe and watch and you know, pay close attention and listen to what be going on. That's basically what it is. So with that being said, you know, I really do fuck with Ty. You feel me? I fuck with him hard. I don't care what nobody say. I fuck with Ty. Ty is very cool. Like, that's one of my bitches that I would love being around every motherfucking day. You know, I love being around you know, Ty, I like being around really all my friends, but shit, we be having fun. And yes, he is going to Miami with me for my birthday. That's the idea right there. So yeah. And we're back again with a motherfucking another one. That's all I had to say. You know what I'm saying? And y'all make sure y'all follow me on Instagram. Make sure y'all follow me on TikTok. And also make sure y'all subscribe to my YouTube channel because it's up from here. And it just dead on it. Oh shit.